Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. This is Sama from the Naqabi Darwis, and I'm reading this book, The Ideal Muslimah. Link in the description box, inshallah. So this section is entitled, She Frequently Repeats Dua, Supplications, Described in the Hadith. And alhamdulillah, one of my favorite books for dua and supplications is the Husn al-Muslim, The Fortress of the Muslim book. It's a very small and very handy book because you can take it with you anywhere you go. And subhanAllah, there's so many dua for different things, different times of the day, going and leaving your house, you know, entering your house, going to the market, traveling, returning from traveling, dua for new parents. It's subhanAllah, like literally everything that you can think of, from waking to sleeping, getting dressed, undressing, everything. SubhanAllah, look how our religion has been so perfectly designed for us, subhanAllah. And obviously these things, reciting these du'as and repeating them, memorizing them, is not obligatory upon us to do so, but look how many benefits are waiting, available for us to gain if we do memorize these du'a and we use them at the appropriate time, subhanAllah. You know, for some of us who might find it hard to think of things to ask for from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or think of things to say, we have these prescribed du'a for us, which are tailor-made, you know, perfectly, you know, revealed for us, that we can inshallah benefit from them, subhanAllah. So we don't have any excuse, and we can also use these du'a to, you know, make our religion keep fresh. You know, you learn something new each time, keep increasing and building upon your knowledge of the deen, and inshallah increasing your iman. Memorizing these du'as and repeating them throughout the day, you know, having that remembrance, constant remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it helps you to, you know, keep your heart connected to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as well, which is very important. And when your heart is connected to Allah and your mind is focused and always remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then there's less opportunity for the shaitan to come and bring foolish and evil thoughts to your mind, inshallah. And for those of us who are non-Arabic speaking like myself, not only memorizing the du'a, but the meanings of the du'a as well, and trying to look at the words, what each of them mean. This is a step towards our journey to learning the Arabic language, inshallah ta'ala. Inshallah you benefited. Jazakallah khair for listening. Anything that I've said which is correct is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and anything that I've said which is incorrect is from myself, and Allah knows best. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.